2 games lang naman, but still it is going to be statement pa rin yun na they really know how to run this hero for their certain lineup. So ako ang titignan ko lang dito for the side of NXP Solid, himayin natin yung mga win requirements nila, yung checklist nila to win, yung requirements. I think dapat medyo mag-ingat sila dito sa Alice.
Yes.
Ang daming pwedeng kuhaan sa kanila dito ng Blood Oath. You have the Popol and Koopa. Si Koopa nandun din. Si Popol and si Koopa nandun. So, it's actually an extra target. So, they should be able or they should be able to end this game ng mabilis. Unless gusto nilang mag-scale si Alice. And that would be disastrous for their side.
Yeah, that's exactly something that you want to avoid as we go into Game 2 of Blacklist International versus NXP Solid. Yung kaninang game natin, that was contender for second longest game of the season so far. Yung una is sila din. Yeah. The longest game so far for the season is sila versus NXP versus Execration. And that was the long 2-1 that we saw. So ngayon, feeling ko gusto, it's gonna be another one. Possible naman. With the lineups, they have a lot of wave clear on both sides and big team fight capability.
And look at the, oh, 2-man stun dito. Renej actually getting caught. Pero tignan natin dito kung meron bang mangyayaring pag-intercept. That won't happen. And ito na nga sinasabi din natin for Blacklist International, since napag-usapan natin yung win conditions na in episode, pag-usapan natin yung Blacklist International. Utilize si Eson with this Atlas. Nakita natin kung paano yung gamitin to against Onyx PH. Kung paano yung sinetup yung lahat ng pickups doon for full clip.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel that enable the full clip is still a thing dito onto the side of Blacklist International. There is Dexstar on the stacks din. Patagalin nyo yung laro just enough for Dexstar to get the stacks kung hindi nyo man makuha yung early snowball. And doon kayo mananalo. So those are the two requirements para sa magkabilang teams.
Yep. Win conditions are gonna be very similar for both of these players. Obviously, with the picks that they have, yung Lancelot as well as this Ling. Now, we are going to see a little bit of a slower game compared to kanina, which is a sign na parang on the way nga tayo dun sa medyo long games natin.
For sure. Kasi kung papansinin mo kanina, ano naman eh, nag-ingat pa rin yung dalawang team eh. They still respected each other. And si Renej dito will still get that coin. Siya pa rin ang nakakuha.
Yep, exactly. And that's the power of the FAMs, man. Mahirap contest ang FAMs early game. Like, there's a lot of times na yung FAMs na to is going to be... It's sometimes FAMs is tankier than the actual tank early game.
And si Eson dito nahuli. And here comes the Feathered Airstrike. Will it matter, though? That is the question. Yawi dito, hinahabol ni Full Clip. Does he have enough damage? Tempest of Blades nandun. And look at that. Pumasok na lang si Full Clip dito. He converts that into a kill. And Alice dito ang pinaka-next target for Renej. He will take that down. And tatandaan natin na this is a bad matchup para sa isang Alice.
That's true.
Yung Thams-Alice na matchup na yan, that's really not going to the side of Alice anytime soon.
He actually fought kanina si Yawi was gonna survive. So far, this Thams-Alice lineup matchup is something that we've seen actually previously. Mm-hmm. We've seen this recently. And it really went so bad for the Alice.
Mm-hmm.
So, again, super surprised with the plays that Blacklist are pulling off. Surprised na si Yawi din yung nagiging target nila, which is dapat hindi. So, Blacklist here is just coming up with new stuff here to impress us.
MB dito, hinahawi-hawi ni Edward. Tatandaan mo pag ang buhangin, pinainit mo, nagiging glass.
Oo, tama yan. Diba? So,
easy lang.
Malupit.
Easy lang.
Oh. Mamaya, puno na ng ano yan. Matapakan nyo pa yan.
Matapabubog. Diba?
Mabubog.
Okay, mabubog dyan.
Okay, mabubog.
Still, onto the bottom lane. Bottom lane na Rockheart, kinukuha na lang nila yung turrets dito. They know that they cannot contest that because of the innate nature ng H2O Lancelot na yan. And look at that, Chester dito will be the target. Full clip dito, can he take that kill? Yes, he will. Renej, on the other hand, gusto niyo pa rin talaga lumaban. Full clip dito, tumatakbo. He has the Finch Boys and he will get away.
So compared to last game though, dalawa na lang ang instant lockdown dito ng NXP for against a Ling. Which is going to be, obviously, Chester on the Popol and Koopa and Yawi. So other than that, it's going to be very hard to keep Full Clip locked in compared to last game that there was a long duration na-locked up potential. Uy. So, ito yung magi... Kala ko makuha.
Pumapasok-pasok si Fulgit ng gano'n. And,
mainit.
He really just tried to get that certain, you know, grab coin para ma-accelerate lang yung farm dito ni Ling, ni Full Clip, but still, it won't really matter as meron na namang nangyayaring laban dito sa may taas and they will go for the chase. They know that they have the upper hand. MB dito falling very low. Wala siya Firaga armor and look at this. Full Clip unloading
grabe
on everyone.
Naman.
Full Clip is activated, ladies and gentlemen.
Grabe. Earlier, he was just on the bottom part of the map trying to steal that coin and all of a sudden, he was fighting on the top lane very easily. And ito na nga yung pinasabi natin about Full Clip. There's a reason why he stopped KDA right now. He does a lot of things, especially given the right heroes. And Ling pa ang gamit niya ngayon.
Full Clip dito. Nakita mo yung damage output sa kanya. You really have to respect kung
respeto
ano man.
Respeto pa rin kay H2,
respeto
man.
Pa rin kay H2.
You gotta take care, bro.
Oo, kailangan mag-ingat ka talaga. Thorn Rose talaga ang magiging pinakalaban mo dito. Pero in terms of getting these buffs, Retribution and Thorn Rose, ang ayaw mong makita. Mm-hmm. Although onto the bottom lane, Dexter dito is getting priority over two lanes.
Which is pretty good, I would say. Still pretty good. Now, Yawi, nag-aabang pa rin. And I think ayaw nilang ibigay yung turtle na to. Setup will be very crucial here in the timer. You want to get that third turtle if possible, especially if you're blacklist. And NXP ngayon ang zoom-zone around the bottom lane.
Mm-hmm. Eson, on the other hand, nandito siya, nahulid siya dito ng side ng NXP solid. Fatal Links is there. It will not be able to save him, pero sabi ni Aqua dito, sige, pwede ako umalis. Yung bird form niya, yung wings by wings, is makakancel. Yawi going in, and look at this map control for the side of NXP solid. They're actually making it work. H2O, nasa third nila sila dito. Rene J, nagsusuntukan sila dito ni Edward, and look at MB preemptively going straight for Edward dito with the last insanity. Tignan natin dito kung ano mangyayari dito sa may fight na to. Edward trying to get away. Kinagat-kagat siya ng aso and that Chichu Dog will get the kill.
And of course, the turtle will be going over to NXP solid pa rin. H2O getting everything he wants in that fight. Yawi on setup.
Mm-hmm. Pero dito sila, dito, ito talaga yung mahirap na part. Yung pag-push. Mm. Yung mga ganyang maliliit na lang na HP. As long as Aqua is there,
wave clear.
Mabilis ang wave clear sa isang feathered airstrike. So, kailangan nila mahanap yung way na matatanggal nila si Aqua sa may mapa before they push. Kasi naniniwala ako, kaya na nila mag-push ngayon ng diretso. They
I
have
think
their
so.
Items.
Malakas na yung damage output ng NXP. So, kailangan lang mahanap ni Chester or ni Yawi ng si Aqua, which will be a bit difficult considering yung mga positioning na ginagawa ni Aqua ngayon. Pero if they pull it off, pag natanggal lang nila isa, ito lang si Farsang to, they will be able to make a big push.
Ito na yung ginawa na ni Chester.
Binato na lang yun.
Ito na. Sige.
Sige, kaya na yan.
Sugurin mo na yan, dog. Oh. Okay na yan.
Petch my tower.
Petch my tower na. Okay, pwede na yan. At least nakukuha na natin yung middle lane nila. And that is going to be big. A big advantage for the side of NXP solid. Pero ito na naman si Yawi with the initiation. Full Clip getting caught out. H2O done. Going for the slide and taking down that Link.
That's what we're slide, talking about, boy. Ito na yung sinasabi natin. Yawi on the Kufra. Para na siyang sobrang natural na niya, di ba? Sobrang, it's just comfort. Kung comfort lang, ito na yun. Max level.
Mm-hmm. H2O getting out. Yawi dito will be the sacrifice. Magiging sacrifice kaya. Ooh. And he will get a Cyclone Eye.
Grabe. Inahabot siya. Layo na inahabot na.
And nakatakas pa si Yawi.
See, well, just exactly what I'm talking about. These things are so natural for him already. He has navigated thousands of Kufra games for sure. And this is not gonna be any different.
Mm-hmm. Feeling ko, ban talaga eh. Feeling baban talaga mo talaga yung Kufra eh, no?
Feeling ko talaga eh. Parang mali, no? Mali na binibigay mo talaga yun. At the same time naman, goods talaga yung ginagawa ng team to keep it up and for Chester to allow a lot of these stunts. Yung ginagawa niyang panghuli, malaking bagay din yun.
I mean, naniniwala naman ako na may plano sana yung may plano yung Blacklist International for that Kufra. Kaya nila hindi binan. Mm. But still, they're reminded of why it was a threat in the first place nung game number one.
Exactly. Ito yun eh. Diba? Ito
and
yun.
They get another kill on Eson. Eson dito, hindi na talaga siya na-activate. And the only thing that is saving Blacklist International dito from outright losing this game is that Farsa. Akwa is doing a great job. Hindi siya nagpapahuli basta-basta yep. dito.
Edward, though, getting caught na naman on the top side. Plus, nabigay pa, probably, ng Lord. No one is here to contest. Napakalayo ni Full Clip. Dito sa Lord na to. I don't think that's gonna be anytime soon. And I guess ito yung gagawin mo. If you're Full Clip in this regard, if you're Blacklist, sabihin mo, mag-push ka na lang. Just keep the minion waves in control. Para at least mamaya, pag nasalo natin yung Lord, isang lane lang or dalawang lane lang ang kalaban natin.
And we are actually, we could be proven wrong by NXP Solid dito. Kasi sinabi nga natin kanina na baka nga mag-2-1 to. But right now,
2-0 gusto nila, man.
Gusto ng NXP Solid 2-0.
Oo.
And beyond expectations, ang mga nangyayari dito, because we know that these are two very talented teams.
Absolutely. I mean, they gotta come up with something and something fast here because Blacklist, medyo nahihirapan na sila to secure the waves. And even Aqua's wave clear and Dexstar is sobrang baba na din.
Tignan mo yung aso. Lumaki yung aso habang inaagat dito. Si Full Clip. But still, that is the Lord. Will it take down yung turret? Hindi naman. Kahit papano, Yawi is there waiting for the proper time. Nakita siya ng Fedun Airstrike. At tignan natin kung Yawi? May aabot siya ng talon dito. He will actually stop it. Cancel niya dito yon. And Edward is the next target. H2. Look at H2. Wow. Napalhod si Khalid dun sa may harap. Edward not really looking at what damage output H2O has. Ito yung isa sa mga pinaka-importanteng part for the side of Blacklist International. Now, they are down. Pero hindi pa agad-agad makakapush dito yung NXP Solid. Yes. Because of the Farsa nga. Kasi kailangan talaga nila mahuli yung Farsa muna.
Exactly. And it's gonna be very difficult. Pero, unti kakachika-chain na lang natin yung tower, sabi ng NXP. I think that is gonna be the case here. Gusto sanang patagalin sana ng Blacklist to, pero ayaw na talaga ng NXP. They want to close this out. And they know, alam nila na kaya nila.
Pinipressure nila dito yung mga wave. Kumbaga, ang mangyayari, gagamit si Farsa sa isang wave ng Fedun Airstrike. Si H2O, kamunti ka na mahuli doon. Full Clip dito, going for the chase. He will take down H2O. Is this the turnaround na hinahanap ng Blacklist International? Chester trying to get away. Pero sabi ni Dexstar, ladies and gentlemen, ako na ang bahala dito. Fedun Airstrike will connect on that Chester, Popol, and Koopa, and it will go down. Gillette instant replay, hashtag shave the day. What happened there, Rockhart?
Actually, kaya sana nilang consistent yung tuloy yung teamfight na to. The problem was, H2 was already low nung pumasok siya. That's why, napa-phantom execution siya palalbas. And after that, medyo kinulang na nabawas yung NXP. And because of that, they were able to concede and Blacklist was able to defend that Lord. Sorry, that push on the bottom.
So, aggression for aggression dito. And nakita mo naman si Edward, tinapon na lang yung kanyang ultimate to stop the aggression na pinapakita ng NXP Solid. Okay, at least gumagawa sila ng way dito para, alam mo yon, hindi sila mag-bleed out. Kumbaga, kailangan mo remedyon yung mga bagay-bagay na or yung mga butas na binibigay sa iyo dito ng NXP Solid. Kasi yung Blacklist International ngayon, unti-unti na silang sinisira. Isipin na lang bahay sila. Unti-unti sinisira ng NXP Solid yung pundasyon. At kailangan nilang ayusin yon isa-isa. And this is the remedies na nakikita nila. And look at that, Fatal Links, Fedun Airstrike will connect. Damage won't be enough. Pero sabi ni Edward dito, the time is now. Ito na ang paglaban natin. Yawi dito will be the next target. Tignan natin kung ano mangyayari. He will go down as well. H2O, tina-target siya dito ni Full Clip. Sina-size up siya dito. Fedun Airstrike will be there for a second time around. And sabi ni Full Clip, huwag na natin i-go. Nakuha na natin yung pakay natin.
Yep. And todo bigay si Full Clip dito sa laban na to. Talagang siya yung nasa front all the time. And he's also getting a lot of the kills. So that's actually where you want to be. 7-1 on that link. So now it's going to be the waiting game. At habang tumatagal yung laban na to, mas pumapabor sa Blacklist. Their scaling, even on their mages, is going to be good. So, kailangan bantayan ng NXP itong si Aqua din and si Dexstar. Kasi, Aqua's gonna go down, but Dexstar, as an Alice, kita natin na pag nakastacks ng Anli yan, hindi mo din kayang tiisin yung bawas niya mamaya.
Ito na yung sinasabi natin. It's taking time for NXP Solid to finish this. There's a chance na yung Alice dito yung talaga magkaroon ng isang malaking impact mamaya into this game.
Aha.
Pero andito na si Full Clip in the area. medyo natumba siya dito. Medyo nalaglag pa nga siya dito. Tempest of Blades, he will use it. Yawi dito, going for the bouncing ball. Naipit nila si Full Clip dito. And look at that dodge. Nakaiwas siya dun sa may likod naman. There is a Rene J fight na nangyayari. This is a 4v1. Masasalba kaya siya dito ng mga teammates niya? Sabi ni Rene J, never say die. Laban na lang.
Naka-vengeance naman eh. And that is a Tamos that bought a lot of time para sa ibang members ng NXP Solid. So far, they need to reset. Kailangan mag-reset nila and they need to wait for the Lord push happening down right now. Pero si Rene J and si H2O hindi pa available para lumaban. Mm-hmm. So feeling ko masasayang din yung Lord take. Pero the good thing about that is nakuha na NXP Lord. Yun yung pinakamalaking bagay doon. Because if not, it's going to be a really strong.
Alam mo yung pinakaiba talaga ng game na to para sa akin yung ano eh, yung impact ni Rene J sa game. Yung first game medyo naging mahirap for the side of NXP Solid because Rene J was actually shut down for quite some time. Pero ngayon si Rene J nakikita mo na talagang enabled siya para para mangharas at para maging frontline. Nakikita mo yung difference eh. For Blacklist International naman, they're doing the right place na nakakalabas na sila ngayon ng base nila.
Important.
That is an improvement sa way of life nila dito sa mapa na to. But the thing is, itong mga pagiging aggressive na ganito, yung paglabas-labas ng mapa, it could lead to pickoffs din kasi. So NXP Solid, they should be on the lookout para dun sa mga nagsosolo-solo. Katulad nung ginawa nila kanina kay Edward nung game number 1 na they utilize itong si H2O at si Rene J na magkasama sila lagi at sinusubukan nila i-pick off yung mga big targets dito sa may mapa.
Yep. In first one, mas matindi kanina yun. But right now, it's gonna be another big one. Full Clip here. Yawi gonna be the target for the rest of Blacklist International. They take one for none. And
oy, nahuli nila yung Farsa.
Nahuli nila yung Farsa.
And nagawa ni Rene J yung trabaho niya. Pero this is a 3v4. Ipipilit pa ba nila to? That is the question. Andyan din si Popol. So make this a 3.5v4.
3.5v4?
Hindi kasi may aso eh. May aso eh. May aso eh.
May bilang yun. May bilang yun. Like ngayon, siya yung bumabawas. Siya yung nasa harapan. Oh. Babalikin muna ni Chester. Dexter in the middle of the fight. Again, once more, ultimate activated. No need for the Winter Crunch on MB goes down.
And Dexter dito is the target for H2O. H2O dito na pinpoint niya na kung sino yung kailangan niya i-take down. And look at the HP
My
bar
God.
Going up for Edward. Tutumba dito si H2O. And gumagawa na ng paraan yung Blacklist International.
Yep.
Slowly but surely, climbing up the ranks ulit. And ito yung sinasabi natin, as the game progresses, so the scaling.
And the gold is going now in favor of Blacklist kahit na medyo kulang sila ng inhibitor. Malaki ang kinlime na gold difference doon ng Blacklist. I'm a little surprised na they can still keep this going. Now, scaled up na maayos si Kuya Dexter din. He's doing a lot more in the team fights. Kaya napapatagal yung laban ngayon. And NXT Solid, they are starting to lose momentum.
Mm-hmm. And nandito na si Full Clip din. Nakuha niya yung items niya. 913. Solid performance from both teams, pero tignan natin kung aabot nga ba tayo ng pangatlong game. Blacklist International fans, lahat sila ngayon, pakakamdam ko, nagtatatalon talaga eh kasi nababaliktad na eh. Pero yung NXP Solid fans, they are, I think, alam mo yon parang nagtitiwala pa rin sila na kaya pa rin ibaliktad to. So, dyan lang kayo. And enjoy lang natin.
It's not over. It's not over, kumbaga.
It's not over.
It's not over till it's over. 3K gold lead is something na hindi naman ganun ka laking bagay at 18 minutes into the game. Lord aakit na naman and I think this is going to be a better positioning here for Blacklist compared kanina na sila ay medyo umaagaw-agaw lang.
Mm-hmm. And remember, katulad ng sinabi natin, in terms of securing that, kailangan makapwesto agad yung Blacklist International and hindi palapitin sa H2.
Yun nga yun. Parang yung ginawa din nila kanina kay Full Clip nung Lancelot.
Oo, kailangan ilayo nila.
Kailangan ilayo nila.
Kung ano yung paghahatak kanina ng NXP Solid para hindi ganun makalapit yun si Full Clip dun sa My Lord, ganun din yung kailangan nilang gawin.
Tama. So, it, ang magandang ginagawa naman dito ng NXP is they're just making Blacklist guests. Hindi sila nagpapakita masyado sa mapa. So, hindi alam, ano ba, nag-setup na ba ng Lord to? Or, ano ba, hinahunting ba tayo? Or they trying to go for something? Pero looks like si Rene J ang mapapalaban dito sa baba a little bit, just a little bit, patikin lang. Kumbaga, sa magiging laban na mangyari mamaya.
And alam na ni full clip ngayon na may damage siya. And look at Yawi, na-perse siya ng immediate flicker. So, walang isang mabilis dito na pag-entrada mamaya, na flicker to Tyrant's that ultimate Rage. Tyrant's Rage. Walang ganun. So, at least they take that out. Pero for Eson dito, the same thing happened. Wala na rin siyang flicker dito. So, there's no flicker. Fatal Links.
Natanggal ang mga tanke.
Kagalingan sila ngayon mag-initiate with their own devices. Na walang advantage.
Yep. So, tignan natin sino ang lalamang sa ganun. Pero for now, wave control muna tayo. Wave control muna tayo for both of these teams. And waiting for the waves to go in line. I think yun lang inaantay din ng Blacklist eh. Itong Lord medyo napapanis na dito sa gilid. Hindi ko alam kung magiging priority ba to. Pero kung NXP sana nag-Lord ngayon, they probably could know. Pero hindi din alam kasi ng NXP kung nasan ba ang pwesto talaga ng Blacklist ngayon. Kasi Full Clip and Edward are just near the bushes. They're not showing on the lane.
Mm-hmm. And that is going to be a stop muna sa mga pangyayari dito. Just chill.
Pang-longest games na naman to eh.
Chillax, ladies and gentlemen. And mag-enjoy lang tayo kung ano nangyayari ngayon. Kasi kami, ina-enjoy na lang din talaga namin to. Kumbaga, this is NXP Solid versus Blacklist International. This is a really good series, ladies and gentlemen. Maganda yung performance nila into the early game. Pero kasi ito yung tinatawag nating CISO eh. Kumbaga, the rubber band. Tinatawag na if you pull yung rubber band, kung sabihin natin, kung in-stretch mo yung rubber band, hinila mo, there's a chance na baka there's a chance na baka yung sa daliri mo matanggal siya at ikaw yung masaktan din.
Yun nga.
Diba? So, ito yung tinatawag natin rubber band effect for these games. So, may balik. Just because of the kills na nakukuha mo. And they got a kill on H2O.
And I'm super surprised that they're also burning down a lot of flickers para lang mag-check nung mga bushes. That goes to show na malaki ang priority ng isang maling galaw dito sa laban na to. That's why talagang sure na sila na pag na-take down yung isang tanke, yun na yun eh. Kaya hindi na nila tinitiis, hindi na sila nagtitake ng chance. Talagang pag feeling nila hindi na kaya, we will have to flicker out. Talagang mag-check out ng bush. Kung may tao doon, edi talagang bahala na. Basta wag lang ako mamatay. Maubos na lahat ng skills ko, wag lang ako mamatay. Mm.
Kala ko nga sabihin mo doon, hindi na sila magti-TikTok eh.
Naku, mahirap yun.
Hindi kaya. Hindi kaya. Yung TikTok is, TikTok is life.
Oh. Diba?
Masaya tayo doon eh.
Well, alam mo yan.
alam natin yan.
Well, you hanapin nyo lang si Butter sa TikTok.
Huwag nyo na hanapin. Naku. Pero ito, tignan mo. Chill lang sila. Wala masyadong reaction. And si Yawi, parang lagi ko siya nakikita nakapikit for some
kanina,
reason.
Kanina, actually, napansin ko din yung kanina
din,
pa eh.
Kagabi, di ba?
Kagabi din.
Medyo nakapikit siya lagi. I don't know kung nakapikit talaga siya. But it's more on the idea lang siguro na chill.
Chill lang yun. Or, ayaw na yung ma-pressure ba?
Ayaw na lang ma-pressure. Pwiling ko chill na lang. Pero ito, tingnan mo, si Eson dito, ganyan na ganyan yung pwesto ni Eson lagi. Kung may napapansin tayo sa NXT,
kulang na lang
may
mga numero.
Tayo. Oh, yan.
Mga numero ang dumadating.
Na ni Eson, eh. Nagka-calculate na. Sinasabi ni Eson, sana paano ko ba i-initiate ng maayos to? Feeling ko, kaya ko naman eh. Pero,
sinisimula na niya ang kalkulasyon.
Sinisimula na natin yung kalkulasyon. And we will head back into the game. Nag-ready na sila dito. Paano nga ba makukonclude etong game number 2 na true? Malalaman na natin.
Feeling ko pang ano na naman to. Malalaman
na natin yan
na
in just a bit. And we are heading into the 20-minute mark. Look at this. H2O na paalis. Fatal Links will connect. And that was the initiation na hinahanap nila. H2O falling full very clip. Low. Dexter dito onto the backlines. Let's see kung ano pa mangyayari. Full clip. Mga kaibigan, tinutuhog-tuhog yung mga tao dito sa may likod. Full clip.
Ayun na, nahuli nila.
No, he won't. Yawi is still there. Edward here with a two-man setup. And my goodness, Blacklist International, they are back in it.
They're back. Absolutely. One guy remaining dito. Si Chester na lang ang natitira. 30 seconds, 40 seconds sa death timer.
Kaya pala nag-iisip. Kaya pala may nakita ka ng mga number.
Yung setup niya
ni Edward. Yun na pala yung gagawin.
And ano ni Eson?
Yun na pala yung gagawin ni Eson.
Sana may mag-edit.
Feeling ko meron eh. Daddy Shark, kau na.
Daddy Shark ha, right after the post, no? Putik yan, no?
wala.
Nag-launch agad?
Nag-launch agad.
Kinalkula niya yung distansya na gagawin ng
player. Kinalkula niya yung distansya. And ladies and gentlemen, we are heading into game number 3.
Nako po.